it's Jo from Oopsadaisy. Hiya. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. I'm not going to be creating a journal spread. I'm going to be answering a question that I get asked tons on social media. How to get good photos of your journal. I am by no means an expert, so these are just top tips that I have come across by trial and error and also researching online to get a little bit more out of your Instagram feed or your basically your bullet journal photography. So I've got 5 top tips for you. I'm going to be showing some photos of kind of inspiration before and after shots for the different tips. My first top tip, so number one, you'll see it pop up here, is background. So for Instagram, it can be really helpful to have a consistent background to your photos, which gives you kind of a coherent look to the whole feed. What I use for the background for most of my shots is actually this wooden table here. It was the first thing that I purchased when I bought my first house. It's a reclaimed wood table, and I really love the look of it, and it's become part of the look of my feed. I know a lot of people really like kind of a bright white background, something really plain, and it totally depends on how you want your feed to look. I pretty much use this table for all of my Instagram photography, all of my journal photography, to be honest with you, with very few exceptions. And I find by using an interesting background, it brings a bit of life into my photos, so a bit of character and a bit of an insight into kind of my style. So that's my top tip number one, pick a consistent background. Okay, so for tip number two, what equipment do you need to use? Well, you don't need expensive equipment, and that's the key thing. Most of us have an iPhone or basically a camera phone of choice, and the cameras on these phones are excellent, so you don't need another camera. I use this for pretty much all of my journal photography. It's the iPhone XS. What else do I use? My journal. Obviously, a few props, which I'll go through with you in a second. And I do actually have an additional light. So I have a ring light. I'll show you a photo up here. And this I use because the lighting in my house is pretty dire. My house faces in the wrong direction, so I don't get much natural daylight in the living room. So I added in the ring light just to give a brighter look to my pictures, because I'm struggling with them being quite dark and shadowy. So that actually takes me to tip number three, which is lighting. And lighting is so important for your photos. If you have poor lighting, it doesn't show off your spreads to the best of their ability. So if you have got good lighting, natural daylight is by far the best way to light your journal photos. Unfortunately, as I said, I don't have good lighting in my house. So I use a ring light. I don't have it turned up to the max because I don't want that really artificial light look, but I do use it with pretty much all of my photos now. To start off with, I had a pretty inexpensive ring light that totally did the job, to be honest with you. I've invested in a slightly more expensive stand-up setup because I now use it also for the YouTube videos and things, and without it, it's very difficult to record what you're doing clearly. So lighting is key, daylight is best. Tip number four is post-production. So I do use a bit of post-production on my photos, most of which, again, is just the standard iPhone post-production. So I'll go through what I do with my photos with you. For all of my pickies, I crop them post-production normally, so go into the photo app, pick crop the photo the way that you like. Sometimes I have them so that the journal is lying kind of straight across the picture, other times at a bit more of a jaunty angle. By kind of mixing it up, it keeps the spread a little bit different on Instagram. In terms of presets, I really like the preset Vivid Cool, which is an iPhone preset. I have it turned down, so I don't have it at maximum, so I tend to do Vivid Cool at about kind of 75-70, and then if I'm finding that the photos still aren't popping as much as I would like to, sometimes I turn up the brightness a little bit, and sometimes I also crank the sharpness just to make the text pop. That's really all I do in terms of post-production. Oh, with the exception of adding a watermark, I do add a watermark to all of my photos, and I do that in Canva. So I have a setup in Canva where it's a square shot, which is obviously Instagram friendly, and using my brand font, I have Oopsadaisy UK written in white text, and then I just drop the photo behind it and export. I do that so that my photos don't get pinched without my credit, and it also adds a bit of a coherent look to the whole of your spread. That's Daisy singing along. So yeah, that's number four, which is post-production. And I'll show you a shot now that is, this is a shot before post-production. So you can see it's a little bit dark, not quite as poppy as I would like. I like the pages to look a brighter white. And this is the shot after post-production, which is a lot brighter, a lot more poppy. And the final thing that I have on my tip number five, is to make it live. And what I mean by that is to kind of have things in your photo, so props and things, that really add to the spread. So be it pens, I often use a binder clip to hold the page open, but I think it also adds a little bit of interest to the shot. I will often add in the stencils or whatever I've used to create the shot, cups of tea, etc., etc., to make it look like it's a journal that is being used rather than just a sterile shot of a journal page. Something that I love to do but don't do that often is also have your hands in pictures. So holding a pen, holding the journal, again, it just brings your eye into the page and makes it look more lived. You will know if you follow my page that I'm a veterinary nurse, so because of that I don't wear nail varnish very often, and my hands are often a bit of a mess, my nails are very short. So if I had nicer nails, I'd probably have my hands in my pictures a lot more, and I feel like by pointing out, you're all going to be looking at my awful nails now. But yeah, I really like the look of a kind of a shot with a hand, like this one. So that's my top five tips for making your photos live, and giving them a bit of a pop for your Instagram, Facebook, social media spreads. We are joined by another one of my crazy animals now. So not only do I have Daisy singing, but Flora has just come in. Here she is. Hey, Floors. Sorry, professional to the max. Probably another tip is not to let your cats walk all over your journal as well, because too often I create a really lovely journal page and then have paw prints all over it where Flora has jumped all over the page. She's back again. So with that, I'm gonna leave you with a few shots of the equipment and the setup that I will do. Please give us a follow on social media. We are at Oopsadaisy UK. And don't forget to follow us on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. We are creating a lot more spread, and you'll get to see Flora, who loves to cake crash my photos at the most inopportune moment. She's now biting me. So I'm gonna go. Lovely to see you all today. Have a great day.